Pooh.
Happy, what is it today? It is Thursday. It's a beautiful, beautiful day, man. Gratitude. It's really funny. Like, what can I say? I have been meditatively grieving. You know, you could grieve without being upset. You could grieve a loss. And today is a marathon number. What number is it today? It's been 96. Absolutely amazing. And just deciding to challenge myself, I would say, you know, spiritually, mentally, physically. Because I just decided that, okay, if I cannot control what's going on outside of me, like the finance, my desires, I can actually control one thing, and that is how I think, and also my physical body. So I begin to do more yoga, push-ups, reading, and occasionally I'll sleep. I mean, like, sleep and just let my mind wander. But I was just like, I gotta see this whole body of mine. I only have one body. So I decided to just look for it. I was just inside of my own head, trying to money, just get to know who I am. And that's what I've just done the last couple of days, last couple of years. And when I heard that voice this year, I said, I didn't just run 100 marathons and just for you. And to take on those type of challenges, because when everything just runs away from you, it can be, I don't even know how to call it. But eventually, I was able to actually just do that. Just to say, okay, I'm going to run 100 marathons by myself this year. The only thing is, I just share it on the social media. And that's what I've just done. And I've done a lot of yoga with it. Because I said, yes, I want to take control of my body. I want to be in the lotus pose. And the pain that actually comes with doing a lot of push-ups and yoga and running at the same time is just so huge. And still trying to read and still trying to be part of society, whether they're giving your service to others and just showing up and whatever job that needs to be done, doing it diligently without a complaint. And that's what I've done the last 100 days. I showed up at whatever job I'm doing. I just do it. And it isn't about the money, because I just decided to give. I look for places that I could sweep their floor. I go and bug people if they need me to sweep. And that's what I've actually just done. And so, couple of months, and just kind of just ask for support. One of my many friends that have actually supported me a lot is my friend Kevin in California. I really appreciate all your support. Every day I'm always grateful, and it's good to know. And I also have another sister of mine in California too. So it's good to know that those two people always support you. in this kind of, and especially knowing that they have their own lives too. It's really funny how every time I text Kevin, hey Kevin, he would say, what do you need? Next thing I know, he sent me some money. I get that too from Miss Jacqueline too. And I think when you reach that stage and you're not afraid to share your journey of life, it means you're full of abundance. I always say something about doing volunteer work, like I just go down there. It's just that. And it's really funny because I'm the type that used to go into the office and get a job and just, but it isn't like that anymore for me. It's just about that giving my own service. And I think sometimes when you give your own service and let the universe take care of you, you'd be amazed about where you find yourself every time. You're always glowing. I truly live free. I live like a bird. And yes, I'm saying this morning to my friends that have sent me money, Miss Jacqueline and Kevin in California. You are appreciated. Every time I'm just like, wow, appreciate you. And it's just, for me, I guess this whole thing that I know that what I'm doing right now is bigger than who I am. It isn't about me anymore. It's just, it's all about that spiritual connection. And I've come to realize, because people say, why don't you just go get a job? I said, no, I'm a businessman. Until I find out what I need to be doing, I'm really done with playing with myself. And I've been saying that, until I find out what I need to be doing, I am done with playing with myself, because I've done that so much in the past because of fear, and it has left me flat-faced. You just took on any job, and what it has done, it has provided me with a lot of good things, but the truth is, it has never satisfied me. And once that job is gone, you have to deal with the psychological effect. And I think for me, the last one was when I lost a job, and because of it, I got divorced, lost my family. It just made me look at life differently. It really did. Made me look at life differently. And it just changed my whole purpose about life. And I just realized that I have more purpose than many realize. And that's the reason why I just do what the spirit tells me to do. I truly hang with it. And because of it, don't get me wrong, I've lost a lot of friends. Because people don't understand how you could trust the universe. But yes, you can trust the universe to guide you, whatever you want to call it, the Orishas. And there's always going to be that angel in your life that will just be there for you no matter what. So, today, I'm saying marathon number 96. Morning. Marathon number 96, and much love to all the supports. And sometimes you don't need a big support, you don't need a lot of support. Jacqueline and Kevin, most of the time I bought a bunch of avocados with your money. And bananas. Oh, and I buy some bagels too. Yes, I do. But yes, let me go ahead and just say happy Thursday, and one love, and never be afraid to challenge yourself. Real talk. Don't let society make you into a stage to where you never challenge yourself because of fear. Trust me. It isn't that bad being on the street. One love.